Immiserizing Growth. The concept of immiserizing growth was given by Prof Jagdish Bhagawati. In this theory, he established that and free trade plus economic growth. If these two things are happening for a developing country, is going for free trade and it is expanding the economy, so there will be also increase in wealth of the country. But despite this, effect of worsening terms of trade can cause a decline in the social welfare of the country. That means growth and free trade, still the economy is worse off by that. So this is the concept of immiserizing growth. So we can explain the concept of immiserizing growth with the help of a diagram. But before that, we have to make some assumptions. So what are the assumptions? Just like the neoclassical economy, there are two countries, home country and foreign country. So if we consider home country is a developing country and foreign country is a developed country. Second thing we will consider, that for time being we are considering the foreign country, we are not considering the growth of the foreign country, we are considering the growth of the only home country. Next thing, we are considering two commodities, commodity X and commodity Y. Third is the full employment. In the full employment in the home country, that means the resources are perfectly utilized with the help of technology. Next, if we consider that, for now time being, we are considering free and costless trade. And factors are mobile, not perfectly mobile, but they are mobile across the sectors. There are the mobility of the two factors across two sectors. So starting from this, we can explain the concept of immiserizing growth with the help of following diagram, the help of a diagram. So in this diagram, let us consider in horizontal axis we are measuring X. So this is agricultural product, and here we will consider Y, that is industrial product. So initially this is the production possibilities curve of this country. I give it name T1. International terms of trade is represented by the slope of small p. And initially, so A is the post trade production point of country A, and after trade, small p becomes the consumption possibility locus of the country. So here, this country, so indifference on indifference curve I1, community indifference curve, and the equilibrium point is E1. So at right now the country is producing. So right now we can consider that X0 is the production of X, so X1 is the consumption of X, OY0 is the production of Y, OY1 is the consumption of Y. So this country The export of X is now X1, X0 and import of Y is Y0, Y1. Now let us consider that the country expands. So due to growth and trade, due to trade and the country is facing economic growth. So this is the new production possibilities curve. But what happens here? The terms of trade declines due to increase in the export. Or in other words, we have already discussed in the Perishinger hypothesis that whenever there is trade between a developing and a developed country, the terms of trade goes against the developing country. The terms of trade of developing country vis-a-vis the developed counterpart will gradually fall. So there is a decline in terms of trade, which is represented by the slope of a flatter straight line. So after growth, the terms of trade line becomes, terms of trade is represented by the slope of P1. And now we consider the, what will be the new equilibrium? New equilibrium will be represented by the tangency of community indifference curve and post-trade consumption possibility locus, that means P1. So here we see that this is the trade triangle. So now post-trade consumption is, production is OX2. Sorry, post-trade production is OX2 dash and Y2 dash and OY2. So now in this case, what we see? We see that export is almost same. So now export of X becomes X2 dash X2, and import of Y becomes Y2 dash Y2. So what we see here, initially this was the import of Y. Now the import as Y has declined drastically, but export of X is almost the same as previous. So what is the, what we find here? We find here two things. Number one, production of Y is increasing. Domestic production of Y is increasing. Why? Because the domestic production of Y is increasing because relative price of Y in terms of X is increasing. That means Y is being dearer, X is being relatively cheaper. So domestic producers will be willing to produce more Y. Similarly, what do you see? The consumption of Y falls for the country. Why? The reason is same. Due to increase in relative price of Y in terms of X, the consumers reduce the consumption of Y. So first of all, see, domestic production of Y increases, and what do you see? That import by export, the volume of ratio of import by export, this ratio falls. That means each unit of export will command less amount of import now. And second thing, we see that the country previous equilibrium point E1 was on higher community indifference curve I1, and new equilibrium point is on the lower community indifference curve I2. That means there is a decline in social welfare. Now let us explain what are the causes of this type of immiserizing growth. The second thing we can level, that welfare level of the country declines due to expansion of production. Now question is, what is the cause of this decline? The cause may be many. Number one is that if you compare the income elasticity, the country is expanding, then income elasticity of demand of X and Y. So whenever the foreign country, the income of the foreign country increases, the income elasticity of agricultural product is normally low. So due to increase in income level of foreign country, the demand for X does not increase there. Number two, if the country is, home country is more dependent on trade for its foreign exchange, that means there is some kind of dependence of home country on foreign country. So that's why despite the decrease in terms of trade, the home country will continue to export. And third thing is that if we consider that home country wants to earn more foreign exchange, so they will import, they will export more X despite the decline in terms of trade. They will not reduce the export of the commodity X despite a decline in terms of trade. So here what we see, that we see whenever there is free trade and the country expands, due to decline in terms of trade of the developing country, the developing country faces a welfare loss. This is the concept of immiserizing growth. The growth is taking place. Second thing, one more thing we have to remember here. Whenever international price of X falls, that means X is being relatively cheaper in terms of Y. So what will happen? It will also cause a decline in the relative income of the factor which is abundantly used in sector X. That means normally in agricultural sector, labor is more intensively used. So this in this country will have, the labor force of this country will be worse off. This is the most important impact of immiserizing growth. That means in a developing country is a labor abundant country. It exports agricultural product and labor is more intensively used in the agricultural product. So due to this kind of immiserizing growth, the labor force will be worse off because their relative reward of labor will decline. That means the wage rental ratio of the country will decline, and this is the impact on the poorer section of the society.